What's going on, guys? We're here a pretty cool video today, seeing how good a father-son team would be in NHL 20. Obviously, I got this idea after making the brothers team. Also, it's Father's Day this weekend, so I figured this was pretty fitting. Now we're going to start with the LA Kings here again. Tied for the worst rated team in the NHL, along with Ottawa Senators. Figure we'll mix it up, go in the Western Conference. So, the father-son team here actually went with Castle Towns as the city, Lion as the logo. Honestly, I couldn't really find any father-son logo, so I figured the Lion would kind of be like Mufasa and Simba, close enough. Castle down, you know, kings, princes, all father-son related. Top players that you can see, Gordie Howe, Martin Brodeur, and Brett Hull. So, some pretty good players on this team for sure. And as you can see here, the team's 90 overall, which makes us the highest rated team in the Pacific Division, as well as the Western Conference. Only team in the NHL rated higher than us is the Tampa Bay Lightning. So, we should be a lock for the playoffs, and hopefully competing for that Stanley Cup. And real quick, guys, I want to thank ExpressVPN for sponsoring this video. If you've never heard of a VPN, it actually allows you to encrypt your data or reroute your IP address in just one click. Encrypting your data is especially useful as so many websites and services on the internet are always getting hacked. If you have any sensitive information out there, such as emails, passwords, banking information, you want to keep that protected. With ExpressVPN's encryption service, even a hacker with a supercomputer would still take billions of years to crack. I also really enjoy being able to reroute my IP to a different country, as being in Canada, so often there's a video or website that's only available to Americans. It actually works really well on Netflix. Now, I actually learned Canadian Netflix is one of the better ones, as we get the Lord of the Rings trilogy, but if I went to US, you could actually watch Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, which is one of my new favorite movies. Also in the UK, they have Rick and Morty, one of my favorite shows. So just being able to bounce around different countries and get more access to content, whether it be on Netflix, YouTube, whatever, gives you so much more to watch. So if this sounds like something you guys would be interested in, you can find out how you can get 3 months for free by clicking the link in the description box below or going to expressvpn.com/tactics. And next year, guys, I'll show the lines for this team. Now, something glitched as it says team still has rebuilder. Obviously, a 90 overall team is not a rebuilder. It said champion before it edited the lines, so I'm not sure really what happened. But as you can see, we have a pretty good team here. So I was hoping to have a bunch of the fathers and sons playing together. Unfortunately, again, due to chemistry reasons, it just really wasn't possible. They all would have had, like, you know, minus twos, minus threes. So first line here, though, is pretty stacked. You got Brett Hull playing with Max Domi and Gordie Howe. Second line there, you got Brian Bellows playing with Peter Stastny and Matthew Tkachuk. Third line, you got Keith Tkachuk playing with Paul Stastny and Dennis Hall. Dennis Hall is actually Brett Hall's uncle. I would have had Bobby Hall, Brett's dad, on the team. Unfortunately, though, he's not in the game, so figured his uncle was the next best thing. And then fourth line there, you got Claude Lemieux playing with Brady Tkachuk and Alex Steen. Now, I actually wanted like an all Tkachuk line, but I'll show you guys here. I think unless they played fourth line, they were going to get a minus no matter what. Like on the fourth line, I think they got zero. So I figured it just really wasn't worth it. Might as well split them up. I do have them playing together though on a power play. Defense here, unfortunately, we actually only have four defensemen. So top pair there is Mark Howell playing with Al MacInnis. Second pair, you got Ty Domi and Thomas Steen. Honestly, it's not too bad for forwards playing D. Thomas Steen's great defensive stats, 890 awareness, 90 shot block, 92 stick check. And then Ty Domi, honestly, really good defensive stats too as an enforcer. And then bottom pair there, you actually have Keegan Lowe playing with his dad and Kevin Lowe getting a plus three. So it's like a 90 playing with a 74. So the D core there, obviously the two forwards are gonna get minus three, but hopefully because they have good defensive stats, doesn't hurt them too much. Now the goalies actually had to create as there weren't any father-son goalies in the game. So starting goaltender here, Martin Brodeur, 94 overall, 47 years old. Basically for this, I actually just used his previous HUT stats from like NHL 18, I think it was. And actually using his HUT stats, maybe a 94, where in HUT he was a 93. So even though he's 47 years old, I feel like he should still be a pretty good goalie for us. And then backing him up actually is his son, Jeremy Brodeur, 22 years old there, 62 overall. No longer in the game, but he was in the game last year. So I just use the exact same stats to make his player. Fun fact, he actually follows me on Twitter, so I figured I had to include him on this team. Also, too, we actually have a few scratch players who didn't quite make it. So Kiefer Bellows here, his dad's Brian Bellows. He's going to be watching him from the press box. Same with Brendan Lemieux, obviously his dad's Claude Lemieux. And then Ryan MacInnis, his dad's Al MacInnis. So a few scratch players there, all three are sons. Didn't quite make the team. Again, looking at it, it's pretty solid. Special teams here, you can see that first unit. You got Gordie Howe up front, a top five player all time. And on the back end, you have two of the best shots ever in Brett Hull and Al MacInnis. Like, Al MacInnis here, what's he got? 96 slap shot power. And then Brett Hull there, his shot is just ridiculous. Like, are you kidding me? The second unit here, you can see I have all Tkachuks there for the forwards on the second power play. I thought that was pretty cool. Hopefully, you know, they play together. They actually get a plus one on the power play opposed to the regular forward lines. Four-man power play there is basically just our best players. Three-man penalty kill, I've actually got the Steens together, Thomas Steen and Alex Steen. The second unit there doesn't look to be too bad. And then three-man penalty kill, you actually get a minus one on the first one, but for a three-man, that's honestly not too bad either. So again, looking throughout this team, I feel like it's pretty solid. Hoping Brett Hull and Gordie Howe can carry us there on that first line. Max Domi, if he can't perform with those two legends on each of his wings, I don't know what to say. So high hopes for this team again. Should be a playoff team and hopefully a Stanley Cup team. I'm not sure again why it shows rebuilder. Captain C here, I was thinking about maybe doing the three Kachucks, kind of like the three Stalls of the brothers, but I figured you got to give the C to Gordie Howe. So we're giving Gordie the C, we'll give his son one of the A's, and then gave Brett Hull the other A's. I feel like, you know, the Brett and Bobby Hull are a pretty famous father and son duo in the NHL. Also to you guys, I'll just sim ahead to this next game against Vegas, show you their offense, defense, goaltending, also the jerseys, although the jerseys, really nothing too special. Because we had the Lion, it kind of with like Gryffindor colors, so right there you guys can see the away. 96 offense, pretty ridiculous. 94 defense, 82 goaltending. Surprised goaltending is that low, but I guess because the backup is so low rated, but definitely not a rebuilding team. We're pretty good. Home jersey there you have a look at, and then the alternate here. Black, I think, is pretty sharp too. And again, guys, before we get started with the sim, leave that thumbs up. Helps out a bunch. So at the trade deadline now, guys, with a pretty solid record, 37-21-5. And honestly, I was a bit worried about this team at the start of the season. I think we started out like 5-9 or something. Luckily, though, end of November, we just started winning. I think we had like a 6-game win streak there, followed up by another big win streak in December. 10-1 win against the Sharks. Like, I don't know, the father and sons, they just started, you know, playing together. And it shows 37-21-5, third in the Pacific. We're 1 point behind the Coyotes, though, and we have 2 games in hand, so probably going to pass them. Gordie Howe, he's ripping it up. 77 points right now in 63 games. Also, too, I checked our team stats. It's now back to being a champion. So hopefully we can keep this up here and maybe have a shot at that Stanley Cup. And check this out, guys. The regular season's over, and we finished 1 win shy of 50, 49-28-5. We actually lost our last 2 games as well, so had a chance in both of them. I think we went on like a 9-game win streak in March. So this team's had a couple big win streaks. Hopefully we can have another big win streak during the playoffs here. So in our division, finished 1 point behind the Vegas Golden Knights. Not too bad. Brett Hull actually ended up being our scoring leader. 95 points, 46 goals. Honestly, I feel like Brett Hull put in more than that. Especially right now, I have the sim engine set to high scoring. So obviously not too bad though. Beginning of the year, I actually thought we might miss the playoffs. And I was starting to get worried. Like, we have too many legends on the team for that to happen. Gordie Howe also finished with 95, just a bit more assists there. So both those guys did really well. Max Domi had 70, so definitely did play well with them. Could have played a bit better, I think. Peter Stastny, 68. Markow, 61. That's impressive. I thought Al MacInnis would have been the scoring leader for defensemen. Brian Bellows, Matthew Tkachuk, Keith Tkachuk all put 50 in. Brady, though, unfortunately did not have 50. Where is Al MacInnis? 39 points, only 15 goals. Kind of surprising, honestly. Alex Steen, 35 is not too bad. Same with Brady Tkachuk there. So overall, the guys didn't do too bad. Ty Domi, 7 points, worse than the team, but he's an enforcer playing D. Martin Brodeur here, let's see, 38-23-4, 3 shutouts, .904, 2.96, not too bad. His son there had a positive record, so really can't be too upset with that. Take a quick look here and see led the entire league in points. I doubt Hull or Howe. Yeah, they're both on the list, but at the bottom there. Crosby had 110, Panarin 106, Binnenshed 105. What a year from him. Malkin 102, Peterson 100. Dylan Larkin, 98. You'll love to see that. Then we got Hull there and Howe, both tied with Patty Kane. Okay, so, you know, not too bad of a season overall. Take a look here at the regular season standings. We probably finished. I mean, a lot of teams actually, I noticed, plus had 100 points. But, yeah, wow, 103 only had us at 7th. How many teams? 9 teams, 100-plus points. That's one of the most I've ever seen. So, for that to happen, a lot of teams must have just been absolute crap. Let's see. Colorado made the playoffs at the 19th. Wow, so we didn't have to be that good in the West to get a wild card spot. And the worst team, Montreal, 63 points. I did see they fired their coach. I see why. Devil, 67. I guess, yeah, a lot of teams in the 70s. Again, that's going to happen when you have a bunch of teams in the 100s. So I'll see we play here in the first round of the playoffs. I feel like we should have a pretty good matchup. Or actually, it's going to be the Coyotes, right? It's going to be 2 versus 3. So, I mean, Hall used to play for the Coyotes. I think he's on a bit better team, though, with the father-son team. So let's see what happens here. We got Phil Kessel, they got Taylor Hall. I like our chances though. So first 2 games are at home. 5-3 win, 5-1 win. Okay, so the guys are scoring. Maybe could get a bit more defense in front of Brodeur. Game 3, game 4 in Arizona. 5-1 win, we keep winning 5. And a 4-3 win, so there we go. Clean sweep in the first round. And the second round here, guys, we have the Vegas Golden Knights. We're actually playing the first 2 games in Vegas. They got that home ice advantage, but I was gonna say we'll play good in Vegas. Apparently not, 4-2, 2-1. Maybe the fathers and sons, a bit too much time at the tables, I don't know. Game 3 at home, 3-2 OT win, back-to-back 3-2 OT wins. I mean, those are some close games. Boys came up clutch, or not even the boys and the men, I guess. 6-2 win, we're rolling, we got the momentum, just win one of the next two. 6-5 OT win, wow, so 4 straight there, onto the conference finals. Here we go, Dallas Stars, another team Brett Hull's played for. He showed up against Arizona, can we keep it going here? 3-1 loss, 5-1 loss. I mean, Vegas beat us in the first two as well when we were away, so Gotta come home now and big two games here. Not looking good. 5-3. Wow, Dallas sweeps us. Are you kidding me? I mean, we had a good run, I guess, made the conference finals, but I did not want to go out on a sweep. And look at this, guys. I don't mind this sim. Detroit, they're picking first overall. They did jump up from four, though, so hopefully it's just Detroit picking first overall in real life, not the number four seed jumping up. I think that'd be the Senators who would get that. Or no, they're 2-3. I don't know who four is. I'd have to look at it again. You also see there, Capitals win the Stanley Cup. So, I mean, 2 times in 3 years, not too bad for Obi's legacy. Gordie Howe there, 18 points, 14 games in the playoffs. I mean, he showed up for us for sure. We'll see how the rest of the guys did in the playoffs. I don't know how he got swept by the Stars. Like, Hull, 17, he had 10 goals. Stastny was a point per game. Domi, pretty much. How'd Brodeur do? I'm assuming 8-6, 0.9, 3.05. That's not too great. I think his stats were actually slightly better in the regular season, and usually it's like the opposite, and the goalie plays better in the playoffs. 94 overall. I mean, he is 47 years old, but his rating didn't go down at all. I feel like a 94 overall goalie in Brodeur should have played a bit better for us than he did. Playoff tree here, so let's see. Capitals, best of 7 with the Rangers, swept the Senators, how they made the playoffs, and then beat Pittsburgh, I have no idea. Swept the Lightning, then beat the Stars in 6. Also, Buffalo made the playoffs, beat Leafs in 7 before getting swept by the Lightning. So, both Buffalo and Ottawa should not have been in the playoffs, somehow won their first round, but then swept there in the second round. Dallas, of course, swept us and loses best of 6 to Washington. Take a look at the awards here. Maybe we got one. Obviously, no team awards, individual awards, Crosby, Art, Ross. Panarin, though, got the heart. I feel like he has an outside shot to be a nominee this year. Carlson, James Norris, Peterson, Lady Bing, Kako there with the Calder, Carlson, Conn Smythe, Murray, Vezina, Vasilevsky, Liam Jennings, Jarmelson, Bill Masterton. Not looking good for us. Buffalo coach Jack Adams, either him or the Ottawa coach for sure. O'Reilly gets the Selke again. Panarin, Ted Lindsay, so respect for that. And Ovechkin there, Maurice Richard. I thought maybe Brett Hull could have won this for us, but obviously he didn't even put in 50, which kind of surprised by that, especially considering the fact 95 points. You'd think Brett Hull had like 65 goals, 30 assists or something, but what are you going to do? Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Again, I thought it'd be pretty fun to do another family team build for you guys. If you did enjoy this one, make sure you leave that thumbs up. Also, guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. Thank you as always for watching. Have a nice day, guys. Goodbye.